In the movie Blade Runner 2049, it opens with a scene at an edible insect farm. And the farm is growing a type of palm weevil larva, it looks like, which are really high in protein, high in fat. But in typical Hollywood style, they embellished a few details and they threw some wrinkles in which are not really very realistic. So it's cool that they're pushing the whole edible insect idea, or they're at least putting it out there in people's consciousness, but they missed on a few things. The first thing that was really, really strange, I thought, was the guy is farming these larvae of the beetle, but he's got them in giant vats of liquid. It's this greenish-gray liquid, and they're completely submerged. Now, I totally believe, it totally makes sense to me, that in 30 years there's going to be a sort of lab-grown food source for insects to make them more efficient, so that they can eat this food and reproduce quickly in a sort of habitat that's conducive to them growing quickly, reproducing quickly, and having becoming a great protein source. But I don't think that the palm weevil larva is going to evolve in 30 years to the point where it can live completely submerged underwater like a shrimp. That's not gonna happen. So a little bit of suspension of disbelief that these insects, which live in the heart of palm, like they eat palm trees, that's basically what they do. They are in the heart of the palm. That's why there's been an epidemic actually in Southern California of these beetles which came in from Central America and have been eating the palm trees, and you don't notice until the palm tree just all of a sudden turns brown and all the leaves fall off and it dies. That's what they eat. So in Thailand, in Ghana, in other parts of the world, in Vietnam as well, they're farming these insects. But they put them in either in bowls or troughs, or they just put them in big trunks of fallen palm trees, and that's what they eat. And their reproduction cycle, or the cycle of being eggs and then eating the palm tree and becoming edible, a protein source for humans, is very short. It's one of the shortest of all the insects, which is why they're a great sustainable protein source. But the idea that they can go from that, which is their natural habitat, eating the heart of palm, to suddenly living underwater, or whatever this liquid is, which I'll get to in the next point, it's very unrealistic. But talking about suspension of disbelief and realism, what is that liquid? It's this greenish-gray liquid, and the farmer is in some sort of a hazmat suit. So it's like this, he's working with radioactive material or something. Now, if I'm eating a protein source that's basically becoming protein based off what it eats, in Cambodia and in Thailand, the crickets that you eat have a very different taste, whether they eat chicken food or cricket food or just all natural organic rice husk, pumpkin, and different types of leaves. The taste is very different, the nutritional density is very different for those crickets. So if you take a palm weevil larva and you have it eating the heart of palm, basically, which is what it normally does, it's going to become a natural protein source. If you stick it in radioactive material, that's probably gonna affect what you're eating as well. So in the scene, he's totally in a hazmat suit, he's got his gloved hand and he's looking at these larvae, and 2 minutes later he's in the kitchen and he's got them in his bare hand and they're still wriggling around, the same larvae. Now presumably he washed them because they look clean, but then he's offering them to his guest. But the most unrealistic part of the whole portrayal of the edible insect farm and edible insects in general in the year 2049 is that the main character, Blade Runner, Ryan Gosling's character, refuses to eat the insects that he's offered by the farmer. And more, he seems like he's repulsed by the idea. He's just grossed out by the idea of eating insects. Now, that makes absolutely no sense, because in 30 years' time in Los Angeles, I'm sorry, but eating insects is going to be as normal and as accepted as eating chicken is today in 2017. That's the trend that's already starting to happen. People around the world are eating insects, it's very normal. It's just in the West, it's in Europe, and especially in the United States and Canada, that eating insects is like this taboo, disgusting thing. But that's very quickly changing. In 30 years, it's definitely gonna be changing. So that element alone is completely unrealistic. But the other thing is, the replicants would be eating a diet, the replicants are clones in this movie, and so they would be fed a diet that's as efficient as possible, because their masters, however you want to look at it, they would want to maximize profit out of each one of those replicants. And they would want to not be feeding them filet mignon because there's no land. Where are you going to grow cattle? Which is the whole issue of sustainability with edible insects. So they would actually have a diet, most likely, that's very high in edible insects, if not based entirely in entomophagy. So here's the thing. This movie it paints a very dark, dystopian sort of picture of the future. A very bleak future, if you will. And the idea with the edible insects that I took from it, kind of the portrayal that they have, is the future is so terrible that we're all gonna have to be eating insects. But the reality is totally the opposite. The reality is, if we start now looking at edible insects as a totally sustainable, healthy, nutritious food source, and a delicious food source, quite honestly, if you cook them correctly, we don't have to arrive at that point where the future is just terrible and the sun doesn't shine and it's a miserable, depressing place. Because using edible insects, because they're so sustainable, because they reproduce very rapidly, because they're really high in protein, the nutritional profile is amazing. So if we start to look at that as a solution now, we're not gonna arrive at this horrible dystopian future. Well, maybe based on some other factors, if there's a nuclear winter or something, but the reality is we can change that. We can begin to use edible insects now, and in 30 years' time, if that's a mainstay in people's diets around the world, and if we just look at Los Angeles, if it's a mainstay in the United States in big cities, if people are eating edible insects and they're using old abandoned warehouses to reproduce and to grow insects, and they're using a more sustainable food source, then we're not gonna reach this point where we've exhausted all of Earth's resources. That's the beautiful thing about edible insects. Thanks for watching. Now go eat some bugs.